still snowing a little bit, spitting. But everything's got snow. We got 4 to 6 inches, depending on where it landed, how well it stuck. I mean, it's been melting off the last couple hours, but there was 6 inches on this car, on my vehicle, on my Blazer, that I had to wipe off. Now, this is snow. This is the most snow I've ever seen here. It's still snowing. Yep, this is what a Nevada rest stop looks like. And you can camp here. Oh, now don't pull on me now. Boy, this is something. Yep, desert life. I don't want to walk back in there. Too deep. Yeah. Now you stop. Yeah, now you're gonna throw up. Interviews with you're just amazing.
Who John hung out with last night. It's another weird story. But they half of them were saying
I'm just getting ready to close up the shop for the day and look at this. Not really sticking, except on my ramp. I'll have to use the snow shovel one more time, but amazing. It was actually supposed to do this a few days ago, and it didn't. But it's March 18th. Absolutely amazing.
Yeah. Well, continued to snow a little bit overnight and stuck, at least on the lawn, and a few metal surfaces. It's actually still spitting right now. Look at you. Look at you. Now you're all covered with snow, you goof. Look at that. Look at you.
You just want a belly rub, don't you? Yes, you do. You just want a belly rub.
Yeah, she loves belly rubs. And she loves rubbing her face in the snow for some reason. But yeah, March 19th. And it's still snowing around here. Didn't stick on the asphalt much. Any, you know, or even less on the asphalt than it did on the dirt, but yeah, snow. We got more snow this year than previous years that I've been here. I've only been here 3 years now. I moved in here March 6th, 3 years ago, and it's March 19th now. So I celebrated my 3 year anniversary of living here. I actually bought the property in January of 2016 or 17. 16? Well, 3 years ago. And then waited for winter to end before I moved up here because I had to tow trailers and didn't want to tow them through any snow or anything. So I just waited the winter out and then moved up here March 6th. Because that was the last day I had in the park anyway where I was at. So, but yeah, this is strange. Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Good.
That's good.
So yeah, different stuff here. Just sharing it with you. And as you can see, got a little bit of snow on the fence here, and on the plants. Roses haven't popped up yet. It was starting to try and be spring. I turned on the sprinklers and everything. I don't know, let's see. Yeah, they didn't come on or anything. They're only working 2 days a week. But go figure. So, no coronavirus here, not in my yard. We do have one case in the hospital here in this little town, and it's a farm worker. So there's hundreds of farm workers that just came in, and here one of them's got coronavirus, and they stay in close quarters while they're here. So I don't know if they're going to test them all or what. I don't know what's going to happen with that, but that could be our big danger here in this little tiny town when hundreds of people come in on buses from across the border. Now they come in legally, you know, they're all legal, they're legally here for the season, they're migrant workers, but like I say, they're all in close quarter housing, and one of them's got Corona, so they're probably, a lot of them are infected. So I don't know what they're going to do about that. We'll see. In the meantime, you're happy because you like it when it's cold and you like rolling in the snow and all that. Yes, you do.
Thank you, Richard. K7UP. K7KYU.
This is a net on 40 meters, and it's, let me turn it down a bit.
Thank you, Neil. Well, we're trying to stay isolated, that is. WA7RYV.
They're going through check-ins right now. They just hit 100. I'm learning about the different nets on the various bands. This one just seems to be a call, you know, check-in net.
I don't know if they talk about anything other than just checking in. And this is going on during the beginning of the big panic, the coronavirus panic. I saw it coming down. Let me turn this down. Okay, this is a Utah net. So most of these people are in Utah. I did hear a couple call signs from outside the state, but it's a Utah net. I'm in northern Nevada. What ham radio operators practice for and do when it comes time is emergency communications. We handle lots of different types of traffic. Right now it's basically, well, for instance, like the we have a hospital net here, so we are able to keep track of the amount of people that are currently diagnosed with the virus and things all related to that. So we basically just recently everybody's firing up their emergency nets and with control operators and everything. And in my lifetime, we've never really had to do this. Normally you think about disasters like earthquakes, fires, floods, and with all those things, the emergency nets do fire up. And then they're controlling a lot of different traffic very quickly. That's why we practice this sort of thing. This is a different kind of disaster. It's like a train wreck in slow motion. It's really bizarre. Yesterday I went out on the streets, as I have done every day, just to take a look in town, see what's been going on. I've watched places starting to close down. All the casinos are closed now, of course, but a lot of the restaurants are open. I think they're all doing the takeout thing, especially the Mexican restaurants. But of course, McDonald's, Subway, all that stuff, they're all open. And we have a McDonald's and a Subway in our town. The hardware stores are open. I don't know about the lumber yard yet. I don't need any lumber right now. My dog is driving me nuts. She wants attention. When she sees the camera going and me talking, then she knows she's not getting attention. So then you want attention, don't you? Yes, you do. So at any rate, I'm just, you know, hunkering down myself. I'm working on my trailers. I have all the materials I need to do a lot of work for a long time. I saw this coming a few weeks back, about 3 weeks ago. I saw it coming and I decided, you know, I normally do a Walmart trip about this time anyway, so I did a Walmart trip. It was my last dentist appointment to get my new teeth. And I stopped at Walmart and I stocked up, and I normally do that anyway. I go to Walmart about once every 2 or 3 months, and that's about it because it's so far away. But this time I went a little overboard. I didn't have 2 shopping carts full of toilet paper. I always have a lot of toilet paper around here anyway. You know what I am short on? Paper towels. I'm down to a couple of rolls, and I use those a lot in the shop. So I'm going to have to start learning to use rags because, like I said, I went around town yesterday, did a little bit of last minute stuff, a little bit of hardware stuff, stopped into the grocery store. All the normal stuff is out. The shelves are empty on no eggs, no bacon, no sausage. That's my worst fear in life. there's plenty of beer, very little bread, no tomatoes, and no carrots, no corn. Like I say, no paper products at all, no water, and I think that's stupid. I mean, I got a river right across the street, and I have filtering stuff and everything. I have all my filtering equipment and everything, so even if they turn it off, the city water, which the city water here is fine. It's a little hard. It's got a lot of minerals in it, but other than that, it's fine. I filter that, so. And we got a river right across the street, the Walker River. So if they ever did turn off the city water for some reason, you know, no problem.
I have backup electrical power and a solar panel that I can use if need be, but I don't see any reason for the power to go down. So it's a different kind of emergency. We didn't just get bombed. Yeah, this is different. Yeah. I don't know what else to say, you know. So I'm going to keep producing material to help keep you people entertained, because I know a lot of you are going to be home for who knows how long. So I'm going to come up with, I'll be doing trailer stuff, and I'll be doing fun stuff too, because there's a lot of places out here I can go and explore that I haven't done yet. So I guess that's what I'm going to be doing this summer instead of what I had planned, which was a lot of traveling. So no, the traveling's out. So it's just going to be me and the dog in the blazer, and we'll run around all over this place, and I'll bring you some entertainment that way, along with my trailer, normal trailer videos. I've got two sets of viewers. The bigger set is for the trailer videos. The smaller set is for my exploring videos. But I'd like to try and increase the viewage of the exploring videos if I could. So at any rate, yeah. Ham radio operators are very important in most emergencies. What we can do here, I don't know, because see, it's not like we got bombed and we lost communications or anything. We just, it's just, everybody's hunkering down. Basically, we're in sleep mode now. So there's really nothing to talk about emergency-wise yet. Now that could change if you've been watching what's going on in Italy and places like that. It could change if it got that bad here. And plus, you know, people are arming themselves up. Everyone here is armed anyway. I mean, to the hilt. We could hold off a small army. This town could hold off the National Guard as long as they didn't bring in the jets, you know. If you just put all the citizens in this town together, we could probably hold off the National Guard if we include our own law enforcement, which our law enforcement is on our side. Our governor came in and tried to change the gun laws, and our county sheriff said, we ain't going to uphold your new laws with guns and stuff because you're not allowed to do that. You see, what it says in the Constitution is infringement. There shall be no infringement on the Second Amendment. So that means you can't come up with any laws about it. So all the gun laws they have now are actually, in my opinion, unconstitutional, because they're not allowed to make any in the first place, because it's infringement upon the Second Amendment. So I know, fight that in court and see what happens. And anyhow, everybody here is armed to the hilt. We don't have a lot of crime in this town at all, and people are very polite. So at any rate, with that, yeah, we'll get on, and I'm going to continue to live life as normal. I'm just won't have any visitors and no helper. I told the helper to just go home, stay home. She's not doing. He's out running around getting slobbered on, so I don't want him around here anyway. And the dog wants out. Oh, the poor little baby. You want out, don't you? Yeah, you're the in and out dog. You're in and out. I can't put it. I'm going to put a get rid of this slider and put a real man door here, an entry door, so that I can put a doggy door in it. Casinos are closed down. That motel's open. The drugstore is open. Essential stuff, I guess. Boy, since I moved here, I've never seen this street so dead. We have three casinos in town. This Dottie's thing on the right is one of them. Of course, the teen club is closed, but they just opened that. Too bad. Dollar General is open. Of course, they don't have anything I need in there. Bank is open. Well, the ATM is anyway. It's Saturday. that town. Chevron station is open, I guess. Grocery store is open. Looks a little crowded for me. I don't need anything though. Believe it or not, the movie rental place is open. Just amazing. Board of subs, chicken roaster, liquor store is open. Dollar is open. The Maverick gas station is open. $2.65 for regular. I pay 40 cents less than that because of the co-op I deal through. True Value is open. I guess Napa's closed. It is Saturday, but I think they're doing fewer hours now. Or I mean O'Reilly. I don't know if they're open or not. This is Napa. They're open. Alright, that was town. Just like to get out of the house and take the dog for a little ride. Kind of check out what's going on.
Charlie Yankee Golf, was that correct?
Roger, roger.
Gotcha, thank you.